Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Welcome to the 2019 Miss Harvest Homecoming and Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen Scholarship Competition. With Miss Harvest Homecoming 2018, Madeline Stewart, our Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen 2018, Skylar Radwell, and eight of our area's most dynamic teens and young women competing for the scholarships and the exciting positions of Miss Harvest Homecoming and Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen 2019. Due to copyright infringement laws, the use of photography is strictly prohibited during tonight's performance. The use of videotaping is also prohibited. We'll kick off tonight's show with our opening number, choreographed by Lauren McNeely, with our parade of candidates. So sit back, relax, and prepare to be thrilled by the first official Harvest Homecoming Festival event as we celebrate Carnival! Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen, Skylar Radwell. And Miss Harvest Homecoming, Madeline Stewart. And now let's meet our parade of candidates. Vying for the title of Miss Harvest Homecoming 2019 is candidate number one, Meadow Ryan. Candidate number two, Brooklyn Shalfont. Candidate number three, Mallory Bauman. Candidate number four, Michaela Collier. And candidate number five, Elizabeth Halau. Vying for the title of Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen 2019, candidate number one, Lexi Stites. Candidate number two, Leah Trusty. And candidate number three, KG Bouvier. And Beth White, please report backstage this time. We are pleased to announce that our MC tonight is Brent Rogers. Brent Rogers, co-owner of Sounds Unlimited Production, has been in the event business for over 20 years. His ability to hype crowds, DJ, and MC began in high school and has grown into a business planning events locally, regionally, and nationally. His locally owned and operated company, Sounds Unlimited Productions, produces some of the best concerts and events in the area, including Harvest Homecoming, Jeffersonville River Stage, the Barnstable Brown Derby Party, and special events for many of you in the room tonight. Brent strives to orchestrate personal and business connections with individuals and generally see that people are having a good time. He's thrilled to be a part of Miss Harvest Homecoming. Please welcome your MC, Brent Rogers.
Good evening, everyone. What a great opening number. Let's give the ladies a big round of applause. Excellent. Welcome to the 2019 Miss Harvest Homecoming Scholarship Competition. Before we get started, we'd like to ask everyone to please take a moment and silence your cellular device. It's a great opportunity to just take a second. We'll turn that off. I know many of you take photos with those. That's great, but please turn the ringer off or at least put it on vibrate as it may interfere with the competition or the microphones. Thank you. We also have a housekeeping note. Due to an unforeseen circumstance, after the current program was printed, Miss Candidate number six, Sierra Midkiff, will not be with us this evening. All right, so the ladies are excited. We've got a fantastic group competing tonight. During the competition, you'll see the team candidates compete in onstage question, talent, physical fitness, and evening wear. And the Miss Candidates compete in on-stage interview, talent, and social impact statement, and an evening wear category. These areas of judging will decide our next queens. Please cheer for them and encourage them while they're on stage. And remember, before the night is over, we will have our new Miss Harvest Homecoming and Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen who will serve through the Harvest Homecoming Festival in October and represent us at Miss Indiana Scholarship Competitions next June in Zionsville, Indiana. We're gonna jump right in with our first area of competition, the on-stage interview for our Miss candidates. Each candidate will answer a question written by our judges earlier today. This will count as 15% of their overall score. The teens will have their on-stage question combined with their evening wear competition. But first, I'd like to bring Miss Harvest Homecoming, Madeline Stewart, out for a quick chat, and then she'll be asking the candidates their questions. Hello, Madeline.
Hello.
Excellent job on the national anthem.
Thank you very much. It's one of my favorite things to sing.
Of course. So, Madeline, we had a great time over the past year, just sort of hanging out and doing a lot of the events. Tell us a little bit about your experience at the Miss Indiana this year.
Of course. Well, as you may know, Miss Harvest Homecoming goes on to compete at Miss Indiana. My experience this year was truly wonderful. I gained many new friendships. But what I'd say I'm most proud of is the hard work that I put into my social impact initiative, which is I Am That Girl, and it's all about empowering young women to be their best selves. And throughout the years, Miss Harvest Homecoming, I went on school tours with New Albany High School. I did a lot of motivational speaking, and I also partnered with an organization based out of California that gives different art classes to young women to help them build their self-confidence. So I've had such an incredible time doing that on my journey to Miss Indiana.
And all of that through being Miss Harvest Homecoming. So I know, again, as I mentioned, we got to do a lot of events together. Maybe tell us a little bit about your favorite memory as Miss Harvest Homecoming, something fun or something that stood out to you.
Being in the parade was one of the best experiences I've ever had, because when you're riding on the streets of New Albany, you see how much your community is backing you and behind you. They're just such incredible people. I've had so much support. And if my little princess is out there from last year, where is she? Can you give a little yell? There she is! She followed me around the entire year, and I saw how much of an impact I had on her, which is really awesome.
Well, and you're making an impact on a lot of the ladies that you meet through all of the different events. You know, they look up to you, and you guys are always so gracious with your time. You and Skylar were so fantastic as representatives of Harvest Homecoming. So tell us, what's next? What do you have coming up?
Well, really exciting times coming. I attend the University of Notre Dame, and I will be graduating in May with a degree in marketing and romance languages. I also hope to apply for a Fulbright scholarship so that I can go to Europe and study and do some research. And I also recently signed with a modeling and talent agency, and my plans with that are to get signed with a record label, hopefully work for one as well in their marketing department. So.
Big plans. Let's give her a big round of applause. Go ahead and get started with the on-stage interview with candidate number one, Meadow Ryan.
Candidate number one, Meadow Ryan. Your question comes from judge number one, Katie Fondrizi. What one event related to your platform has had the biggest impact on both you and our community?
I feel planning the Give Hope to the Homeless charity concert had the biggest impact on not only myself but my community, because I was able to partner with so many wonderful foundations such as My Dog Eats First and GiveFund, which both provide services to the homeless community in our Southern Indiana and Louisville, Kentucky area. It also had such an impact on me because it was a growing experience. It was one of the first events I was able to organize and host all completely on my own. And as Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen 2016, I was actually able to label it as my Miss America Service Project through the Miss America organization. So I look forward to doing those types of events and partnering with Miss America organization as well as other foundations as Miss Harvest Homecoming this upcoming year.
Thank you, candidate number one, Meadow Ryan. Candidate number two, Brooklyn Chalfont. Your question comes from judge number two, Representative Clear. How do you feel about the recent separation of families at the U.S.-Mexico border? And if you do not agree with the way it has been handled, what would you do differently?
As an educator, every single day I have the opportunity to impact the lives of children around me. And through that experience, I know how important a parent is to a student's success. As far as it goes at the border, I don't know if I necessarily agree with it, but I understand why it's being done. As far as what I would do differently, I think that it would be important for our representatives to go down and witness it in person and see how they feel about it and see if they would enjoy their own children be treated the same way. As Miss Harvest Homecoming, I hope that something that I can do is make every single person in this community feel welcome, whether they're of Latina or Hispanic heritage. Thank you.
Thank you. Candidate number two, Brooklyn Chalfont. Candidate number three, Valerie Bauman. Your question comes from judge number three, Amy Cummins. How can our nation help everyone have access to healthcare?
Our nation can help everyone have access to healthcare by providing for all of the people that need healthcare. I know that sounds very, very, you know, cliche to say, but what we can do is we can, you know, look at those people that need help and we can say, what do you need? Not what you want, but what you need. And a lot of people are focused on what they want in healthcare, but what we really need to focus on is what they need.
Thank you, candidate number three, Valerie Bauman. Candidate number four, Michaela Collier. Your question comes from judge number four, Jesse Ratz. How do you feel about the use of advertisements in schools as a way to supplement funding?
feel like advertisement in schools is okay. I don't really think it's an issue. All schools need funding for important things like books, supplies, and extracurricular events.
Thank you, candidate number four, Michaela Collins. Candidate number five, Elizabeth Halau. Your question comes from judge number five, Holly Cook. If you could change one law in our country, what would it be and why?
If I could change one law within this country, I would change the law that we have to do stricter screenings before people can buy a gun. While I am fully supportive of the Second Amendment, I believe that individuals should have more thorough background checks before they are able to purchase such weapons.
Thank you, candidate number five, Elizabeth Halau.
All right, thank you, ladies, and thank you, Madeline. We'll be seeing Madeline a little bit later in the program. This year marks the 52nd anniversary of the Harvest Homecoming Festival. As you know, every year there is a special theme and pin. This year's theme is Carnival, and it is honoring our 52nd year serving our Southern Indiana community. Tonight, we'll be officially kicking off the festival, and you'll get to be the first to see the annual festival pin. I'd like to introduce some special members of the Harvest Homecoming. Please welcome the Harvest Homecoming president, Art Niemeyer, and I've just learned Art is not with us this evening, but we can give him a nice round of applause. Okay? Thank you, Art. Please welcome to the stage the chairman of the board, Courtney Lewis, and president-elect, Beth White. So I had a question for Art, however, he's not here, so I'm going to make a question up on the fly. Courtney's biggest regret is that she has not been a queen candidate. So Courtney, in the spirit of, you know, the ladies performing, what would your talent be? So as you can see, and Courtney is never at a loss for words, so as you can see, the ladies who are up here, they are doing an amazing job. They have rehearsed, and it's been fantastic for them. Now Courtney has her answer, right? So Courtney, look, we've rehearsed this one. I'm going to start with Beth. Beth, what is the idea behind the pin this year, and who's the designer?
The designer is Jeff Finn, and the idea behind it was fun. Just having a great time and Carnival.
Very nice. Carnival is great. That'll be catchy come October. So Courtney, you've made some changes. It's been an exciting year for the Harvest Homecoming. Tell us something that people can look forward to for this year's festival.
Well, our biggest change right now is we've changed the parade time from noon to 3 o'clock. So we'll have a day full of fun in downtown New Albany. You'll be able to go to the Carnegie Center for Art and History's I Am Public Art project at noon. Then come up and celebrate with us with the kickoff of the festival at 3 o'clock, and then head on down to Bicentennial Park and check out all the floats up close and personal, and that is where I will reveal my talent of karaoke.
Very nice. Well, we were definitely looking forward to not only the parade time change, but of course your karaoke talent. So thank you, ladies. I know we are super excited to see the pin. If you ladies want to step out front a little bit so you can see the screen, we are going to reveal the pin in 3, 2, 1, reveal. So that was a picture of the Harvest Homecoming office and the things that go on a day-to-day basis. So as we mentioned, the show is live, so sometimes things happen. So we will maybe have a pic. There it is. So that is a fantastic pin. And as Beth mentioned, Jeff Finn is the beautiful design. So thank you, Beth. Thank you, Courtney. Let's give them a big round of applause. We will be seeing a lot more of you both in the upcoming month or so. So thank you very much for being here with us. Courtney, do you want to come in? We could walk you both across the stage. Right. It's going to be an exciting year, that is for sure. All right. So, I'd like to bring out one of our special guests. Please welcome to the stage, Miss Indiana 2019, Tierra Taylor. So tell us, what has life been like for you over the past few months?
So life has really been a blessing these past few months. I was not expecting to be Miss Indiana to be selected for Miss Indiana. So to be honored with this privilege has truly been a blessing. And so throughout the past couple weeks, I have been able to go to other local competitions and volunteering at events and making appearances and speaking and just meeting a lot of other Hoosiers. And that is something that I know that I will never forget.
Well, I know you've been traveling and doing a lot of amazing things since you've been crowned. Talk to us a little bit about what your platform is and how you got involved with that.
So my platform is Bringing Advantages to Disadvantaged Youth, and it is all about empowering our young people and giving them the tools that they need to survive. So whether that be young people that are growing up in a low-income household or young people that have a parent that may be incarcerated or even minority youth, I want to do whatever it takes to get that young person where they need to be. Your current circumstances not define where you can go, and I want all young people to know that.
Harvest Homecoming, you know, you're seeing a lot of the kids, and certainly as Miss Indiana, we certainly appreciate you representing our state. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, Tierra Taylor. Thank you, Tierra. We'll be seeing Tierra a little bit later on, and she'll be performing at intermission. So I'd like to introduce some of the people who have the difficult task of choosing your new queens this year. Their full bios are listed in the program. First off, we have Katie Fondrisi. Katie was born and raised in New Albany and is a 2001 graduate of New Albany High School. She earned a Bachelor's of Arts in Music Performance from IUS and a Master's in Music Performance from U of L, later receiving teaching licenses in both music and business. Katie currently teaches business at Floyd Central High School and has a private music studio. Katie competed in both the Miss America and Miss Universe organizations, earning the titles of Miss Harvest Homecoming in 2004, Miss Berea and Area in 2006, and Miss Jeffersontown 2007, placing in the top 10 in both Indiana and Kentucky. Katie enjoys cooking and entertaining for others, traveling and spending time with her animals. Ladies and gentlemen, Katie Fondrisi. State Representative Ed Clear was first elected to the Indiana House in 2008. Now in his sixth term, he represents most of Floyd County, including New Albany, Floyd's Knobs, and Georgetown. During his time in office, Representative Clear has received more than 30 awards for his legislative service and accomplishments. He chaired the House Public Health Committee and continues to champion health and human service issues, as well as policy initiatives in a variety of other areas. He serves on the Education, Public Policy, and Ways and Means Committees, as well as numerous boards in various other leadership roles. Representative Clear is a graduate of Floyd Central High School and Indiana University Southeast. He and his wife, Amy, a teacher, live in New Albany. They have 5 children and 2 grandchildren. Ladies and gentlemen, Representative Clear. Amy Cummins is a lifelong resident of New Albany. She has been involved with Harvest Homecoming for the past 18 years and currently serves as vice president overseeing various events including pumpkin chunking. That's my favorite, by the way. First Financial, State Entertainment, and the Riversfront Admissions. She has been employed by Baptist Hospital Floyd for 29 years in the financial department and acquired a degree in biology from Indiana University Southeast. Amy enjoys spending time with her family and welcomed her first grandchild this year. She enjoys traveling, cooking, home remodeling, and reading. Ladies and gentlemen, Amy Cummins. Yeah. Jesse Raz is the co-host of Morning Play on 106.9 Play and a longtime resident of New Albany. He's grown up coming to the Harvest Homecoming and is excited to be a part of the festival. You'll most likely find him spending time around town with his wife Lindsay and his son Ian, dressed as a superhero or helping with local nonprofits such as Home of the Innocents. Ladies and gentlemen, Jesse Raz. Works in Louisville as an internal auditor at Humana. In her free time, Holly enjoys singing and spending time with her husband, family, and dog, Maxie. Holly is a regular volunteer on the Southeast Christian Church worship team, where she is blessed with the opportunity to lead others in worship with her voice. In 2009, Holly won Harvest Homecoming Idol, and shortly after in 2011, Holly earned a golden ticket to Hollywood on American Idol, where she made the top 150 contestants. Ladies and gentlemen, Holly Cook. We would also like to thank Francie Scott, Field Director of Miss Indiana, who was so generous to come and assist our judges and tabulators. Francie, please stand. Thank you, Francie. Assisting Francie tonight is Dana McNeely. Thank you, Dana. A big thanks to our tabulators, Alicia Skaggs, CPA, and Sarah Hunter, CPA. Please stand to be recognized. And this is a final reminder that there is to be no flash photography or any photography during tonight's competitions. Also, there is no videotaping allowed this evening. Our next phase of competition will be our team candidates in talent. These candidates have worked so hard to be here tonight. The team talent portion counts as 35% of their overall score. We have a wide variety of talents this evening, and I know you're going to enjoy them. Please welcome candidate number one, Lexi Stites, to the stage as she performs a fun and energetic tap dance to the song Happy Dance by Mercy Me. Candidate number two, Leah Trusty, is here to perform Zardes by V. Monty. She has arranged this piece to fit a tuba solo. Now please enjoy a violin piece given a new form.
Thank you.
With just over 5 years of discovering her passion for musical theater, candidate number 3 will be singing Stupid with Love from the smash Broadway hit Mean Girls. During this quirky, upbeat selection, she will take you on a whimsical journey, reminding you what it was like to have your first crush and how silly that made you feel. Candidate number 3, KG Bouvier. Let's give all of them a big round of applause so far. What an amazing show. As we all know, we're so excited and proud of Miss Harvest Homecoming's outstanding teen, Skylar Adwell. Tonight, she'll be performing her state competition song from the musical Anastasia, In My Dreams. Please welcome Miss Harvest Homecoming's outstanding teen, Skylar Adwell. Competition as they are about to compete in talent, which counts as 40% of their overall score. After years of performing with her guitar, Meadow is excited to change it up and try something new. Singing a musical theater piece for the first time, please enjoy candidate number 1, Meadow Ryan, singing They Just Keep Moving the Line from Smash.
started as a rover and then victory was mine. I thought the race was over, but they just keep moving the line. I jumped all of the hurdles to break out of the pack. I started on the outside, then hit the inside track. I won the photo finish. I posed for all the men, but before I got my trophy, well, the race began. Until it's time to drink the wine, I'll toast to resurrection, but they just keep moving the line. Please give me some direction, 'cause they just keep moving the line.
For over 10 years, candidate number two has been pushing the boundaries in sewing and aesthetics. Her colorful and unique designs have been on display from local high school theater stages to national sewing conventions. Enjoy learning about her wardrobe favorites as she gets ready to work to teach the youth of America. Candidate number two, Brooklyn. Singing and dancing in the spotlight on stages across the area. Tonight, she shares her gift with you as she sings Gimme Gimme from the Broadway role brought to life by Sutton Foster in Thoroughly Modern Millie. Please welcome candidate number three, Mallory.
Give me
writing this next piece herself, candidate number four will be reciting a monologue called A Victim's Prayer. Candidate number four, Michaela.
I come to you now to admit my mistakes. I have been beaten more to my feelings I can no longer fake. I have a secret, one that keeps me awake. And I just don't know how much more I can take. This isn't how I remember love at all. Please tell me where I went wrong. This man, he claims to love me, but his actions are very strong. How could it possibly be love if I feel so much pain? What hurts the most is that nobody knows and I'm becoming estranged. I'm not the same person anymore. He's brainwashed me into thinking this is my worth. I stay to help him. He claims I'm what he needs, but I feel like I'm just making it worse. That's why I'm down on my knees begging you, please, Lord, relieve me of this curse. I can't handle much more, and I fear for my life. And every time I see him, I can't help but to cry, because I can't seem to forget the look in his eye as he sat on top of me with his hands around my neck, crushing my windpipe. The last thing I saw was the ceiling as my head got light. And then I lied there motionless with nothing but dark in my sight. Lord, I know I should have came to you first. Many times I've tried, but I felt like it didn't matter anymore, and I thought my only way out was to die. I know that if I stay, my days are numbered, and I can no longer accept that as my fate. So I've decided now, before it's too late. Please take over and release me of this way. God, I ask that I can place this in your hands, and to you I promise my eternal fate. Please save me from this downfall, Lord, and with your endless compassion, help me learn from my mistakes. Enable me to tell my story without shame and to relinquish the idea that I am to blame. I was a victim, but me that no longer explains. Because of you, I am a survivor, and I will survive.
Candidate number five, Elizabeth's love for musical theater and her determination to follow her dreams meet in this beat song from Disney's hit musical, Newsies. Singing Watch What Happens, Elizabeth hopes to inspire listeners to reach for their goals even when they seem unattainable. Judges, you definitely got some work to do tonight. Let's give all of the ladies a big round of applause. So for speaking of talent, it's my pleasure to welcome back to the stage Miss Harvest Homecoming, Madeline Stewart. She'll be performing her Miss Indiana competition piece, singing How Great Thou Art. Please welcome
Madeline Stewart.
Was crowned Miss Indiana's Outstanding Teen 2019 in June. She beautifully represented Indiana at Miss America's Outstanding Teen and placed in the top 15. Please welcome Hadley Abram. Hello, how are you?
How are you?
So good to see you. So tell us, what has it been like being crowned Miss Indiana's Outstanding Teen?
So honestly, it's just been a whirlwind. With being crowned in June and then Miss America's Outstanding Teen in July, we got straight to work. We just immediately began preparing for Miss America's Outstanding Teen. I got an amazing new wardrobe like this from Miss Pris, one of our sponsors, and just preparing for that. I'm really getting ready and then competing at the national level as well.
In addition to being a teen as well, right? And all
yes.
The things that come with that, so I know you're very busy. Tell us about this. What have you been doing since your crowning, right? You've been staying busy, but anything specific that you're into?
So school just started Wednesday. I'm beginning my senior year of high school, and at my high school, I run as well as dance, so I've just been getting back in the swing of those things after the summer.
Very nice. You've had a busy summer, and it looks like it's going to be a busy fall for you as well. So tell us, what are you most excited about? I know it's new, a new experience for you, but what do you think you're most excited about for this new experience?
So this past year was my first year involved in the Miss America organization. So honestly, just being here at this local today is so exciting. I'm just meeting all the new girls and just seeing all the local competitions. I'm so excited to just attend each and every one of those and meet every girl I can in this organization.
Well, that sounds amazing. We certainly appreciate you being here tonight and representing our state. So thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, let's hear it for Miss Indiana's Outstanding Teen 2019, Hadley Abram.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. All right, it is time for the Teen Activewear Competition. The judges will see how well each candidate maintains a lifestyle of good physical fitness, and this will count toward 15% of their overall score. The candidate's sense of confidence and presence, as well as her drive, energy, charisma, and composure are also to be considered. Welcome to the stage, the team candidates, but first, please welcome Skylar Adwell as she leads our team candidates in the fitness routine.
Oh,
of the teen competition. Let's give them all a big round of applause. That completes the first half of our competition. They were all amazing. One more time, a big round of applause for all the candidates. Now we are going to have a short and brief intermission. Also, as a reminder, don't forget to vote for your People's Choice in the lobby. $1 equals one vote. A portion of the proceeds will benefit the Children's Miracle Network. Our teen and Miss winners will be announced on stage and will receive a special plaque. Don't go too far. We'll see you back here in about 15 minutes. 2019 Miss Harvest Homecoming Scholarship Competitions. For those of you that may have made a call during intermission, we remind you again, please turn your phone off or on the library, please, as not to interfere with any of the AV gear or the competition. Thank you. This year's Harvest Homecoming Festival is right around the corner. The Little Miss, Little Master pageants are being held on October 12th. Please visit our website at missharvesthomecoming.com for a flyer and registration form. Also during the festival, be on the lookout for our new queens, as they will be making over 20 appearances throughout the week and will be in their own booth located on Pearl Street. Before we bring our candidates out for evening wear, we'd like to invite all princesses backstage. Please raise the house lights, and princesses, see Kara and Suzanne waving. They'll get you lined up and you may exit through those doors. That is as quiet as I have ever heard of a group of young ladies. Give them a nice round of applause already. We'll be seeing them a little bit later in the program. Now we're going to move on to the most elegant part of our evening, the evening wear competition. This phase in the competition is designed for the candidate to make an on-stage statement of her compelling charm, presence, and personality. The teens will also be answering an on-stage question, and this will count as 25% of their overall score. Assisting with the on-stage question portion is our very own Skylar Adwell. Skylar, please join me on stage. That's where you cheer for Skylar, right? There she is. So Skylar, let's take a moment and get to know you.
Let's do it.
So tell us a little bit about this year as Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen.
I have done so many amazing things with this title. Every single year, the Orange family does everything they can to put this show back on, and I just want to thank them for that, so let's give them a round of applause. I have had so many opportunities with the title of Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen that I never would have been able to have without it, and I'm so thankful in the ways that this has made me grow.
So a couple of things that I've learned about Skylar this year. We've had a pretty good time over the last year. However, in the past, I mentioned my favorite event is the Punkin' Chunkin' contest. And Skylar has been the first queen to come up before they were invited to launch a pumpkin. Skylar came and said, hey, look, I really need to launch one of those pumpkins. That's going to be something we need to do. So Skylar and Madeline both were able to launch pumpkins in the field. So it was great to see your eyes just lit up when you were able to launch that pumpkin, Skylar.
It was a lot of fun. I'm totally down to do it again, even if I'm not a queen. Just saying.
Well, and I can tell you, I know Skylar's got a big year. Tell us a little bit about what's coming up for you.
I am currently in an AP class and an honors class at school, so I'm thinking that I'm probably going to take a year off and be able to focus on my family, friends, along with school, but I'm so excited to watch these other girls grow in the Miss America organization, and I can't wait to be alongside them to cheer them all on.
That is a great. The ladies are certainly making a difference. My daughter, Sally, is 8 years old, and she certainly loves you, and you've been great to her, as you have with many of the young ladies. So, again, thank you, Skylar. Tonight's evening wear competition with our lovely teens and candidate number one, Lexi Stites.
It's not a secret.
A junior at Floyd Central High School, candidate number one, Lexi Stites, is a highly involved in her school's musical theater department. Through her years of performance, she has performed in over 30 musicals, and plans to continue her training in college and pursue a BFA in musical theater and a minor in dance performance.
Do you think that the president should have full access to all social media?
I think that social media has become a huge part of the younger generations of America's life. It's a great outreach point to use, but it must be monitored and used in the right way. Thank you.
Number one, Lucy Sykes.
Candidate number two, Leah Trustee, is the daughter of Catherine Halter and Charles Trustee. She will be attending Purdue University after finishing her years at New Albany High School. Her social impact is awareness of mental illness in teens.
Mental health days off from school that do not affect attendance.
I do believe that students who have mental illness should be allowed days off to recollect and come back to school as healthy as they were before. Otherwise, it will build up and they won't be as great as they would with the day off.
Candidate number three, KG Bouvier, is the daughter of Donnie Sorg of Louisville and Heather Bouvier of New Albany. KG will begin her freshman year at Louisville Collegiate School in 10 short days. KG is looking forward to her time at Collegiate, enrolled in the Global Citizenship Program. After high school, she plans to attend college majoring in either theater or interior design, but she's only 13, that may change. KG's platform is Rethink Plastic, fashionably protecting our planet from plastic.
KG, this question comes from judge number three, Amy Cummins. Having attended both public and private schools, what could be done to make each of these equally rewarding?
I think we can make public school and private school education as equal by maybe focusing more in school and maybe connecting more with the students, because I feel that in private school, you get more connection one-on-one with the teachers, and in public school, you don't get as much as that because you're speaking to a larger class. So if we can open up some more classes and maybe close and maybe divide the classes a little bit smaller, we could all get a better education overall.
Thank you, teen candidates, and let's hear it for all of our teens. And thank you, of course, Skylar. We appreciate you. At this time, it is my pleasure to welcome back to the stage your Miss Indiana's outstanding teen, Hadley Abram. Tonight, she'll be sharing her gift of dance to Let's Be Bad, the song she performed at Miss America's Outstanding Teen. Ladies and gentlemen, Hadley Abram.
Most folks won't believe God. Monkey acts so like it high.
We continue our elegant evening wear competition with our Miss contestants. In this competition phase, our candidates will also have the opportunity to make a short social impact statement. This will count as 20% of their overall score. Let's welcome back Miss Harvest Homecoming, Madeline Stewart, to help me introduce the candidates.
Candidate number one, Meadow Ryan's social impact is music with a meaning.
Music is a universal language, one that is spoken to us all and one that will continue to be heard during my year as Miss Harvest Homecoming.
Daughter of Janine Mulder. She is a senior at Southern Illinois University, where she is majoring in psychology and minoring in economics and communication studies. She aspires to obtain her dual PhD in education and psychology to become a psychology professor.
Brooklyn Chalfont's social impact is Smartest Scholars Initiative.
Arts education opens doors for student literacy and school success. Join me in celebrating smart artists who lead and succeed.
Brooklyn Chalfont is a proud fifth-generation resident of New Albany, Indiana. She is a graduate of Lipscomb University with a Bachelor of Arts in Theater Education. She currently works as a high school teacher, and her ambitions include obtaining a master's degree in arts education and working in curriculum development to integrate the arts into every classroom. Tonight, she wears her grandmother Harriet's prom dress in memory of a strong woman who left a powerful legacy of hope on Southern Indiana, just as she hopes to do through her social impact, the Smartest Scholars Initiative.
Candidate number three, Mallory Bauman's social impact is Random Acts.
Conquering the world with kindness. A simple smile can change. A simple smile between two strangers can change the world.
Mallory Bauman is the daughter of Scott and Kim Bauman of New Albany. She is an honors student and senior at New Albany High School, where she serves as president of the thespian troupe and a member of the National Honor Society. Upon graduation, she hopes to pursue a BFA in musical theater and spend her life performing.
Candidate number four, Michaela Collier's social impact is breaking the silence against domestic violence.
Over 10 million men and women suffer from domestic abuse every year. As Ms. Harvest Homecoming, I will lead victims to safety, educate our young adults, and influence the community to anticipate that this number will no longer exist.
Michaela Collier is the daughter of Brad and Marlena Collier of New Albany. She is currently preparing for her fall semester at the University of Louisville. She plans to finish her undergrad in criminal justice a year early and move on to law school.
Elizabeth Halau's social impact is the AAA project, Accessibility to the Arts for All.
The arts are the only language that allow for true human expression. As Miss Harvest Homecoming, I will ensure that the arts are accessible to all within our community.
Elizabeth Halau is the daughter of Jared and Julie Halau of Georgetown. She is an incoming freshman at Ball State University, where she will pursue a Bachelor's of Fine Arts in Musical Theater. She aspires to perform in New York City while also working as a voice and acting coach. Let's give a round of applause for all of our beautiful Miss candidates. Thank you. Now I'd like to welcome to the stage Miss Indiana, Tierra Taylor. She'll be singing "She Used to Be Mine" for us this evening.
Pageant, I still remember that girl who'll be reckless just enough, who gets hurt but who learns how to toughen up when she's bruised and gets used by a man who can't love. And then
December 19th. This concludes all areas of competition tonight. Let's give everyone a big round of applause. They were amazing. At this time, we'd like to invite all former Miss Harvest Homecoming, Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen, and Preteen Royalty backstage as we'll be recognizing you on our stage this year. Please exit over here to my left where Kara Lawson is standing. I'd now like to welcome Kara Duggan, Princess Camp Coordinator, to the stage.
Thank you, Brent. Good evening, everyone. We have incorporated Princess Camp into our pageant again this year. The purpose of our camp is to give young girls a chance to meet Harvest Homecoming royalty and to be princess for a day. The camp also serves as a fundraiser for the pageant, allowing us to increase the scholarship money that's awarded tonight. Each camp participant received a tiara, t-shirt, autographed photos of our reigning queens, had lunch with the queens and contestants today, and will be featured in our pageant this evening. Joining our contestants for the Princess Camp production number is Madeline Stewart, Skylar Adwell, and the 2019 Miss Harvest Homecoming Princesses.
Step in, get your feet up, go. and her favorite holiday is Christmas. Next, we have Eliana Hofer. Her pets include some goats and chickens, and her favorite accessory is purses. Next, we have Lila Dale. Her favorite color is violet, and she enjoys horseback riding after school. Carly's favorite sports is gymnastics, and her favorite restaurant is El Nopal. Next, we have Maylana Laws. Her favorite color is purple, and really anything that sparkles. And her favorite sport is dancing, dancing, and more dancing. Next, we have Jamie Hatton. Her favorite subject in school is math, and her role model is Skylar Cadwell. Named Spike and Callie, and her favorite subject is art. And next we have Jayla Stiff. Her favorite colors are purple and pink, and when she grows up, she wants to be a real princess.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Kara Lawson, Executive Director for the Miss Harvest Homecoming Scholarship Competitions.
Wow, weren't those ladies and those princesses just elegant, so beautiful? Yeah, give us another round of applause. What a show we have tonight. The tabulators are finalizing the
from all of tonight's competition, as well as the interview phase of competition that happened earlier today. Those scores will determine our queens this evening. Now it's my pleasure to introduce you to our Forever Harvest Homecoming royalty. First, we would like to introduce our Forever preteen. I'd like to welcome to the stage Elise Edwards, Miss Harvest Homecoming's preteen 2015. Please welcome Aubrey Waltz, Miss Harvest Homecoming's preteen 2014. Our Forever Miss Harvest Homecoming Outstanding Teen, I have the pleasure of introducing this evening as my partner in crime and my team director, Lauren McNeely, Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen 2010. We have with us this evening our Forever Miss Harvest Homecoming. We're going to start with Ollie Ballou, Miss Harvest Homecoming 2016. One of our judges this evening, please welcome to the stage Katie Fundrisi, Miss Harvest Homecoming 2004. And as we were just mentioning backstage, we have the place of honor this evening goes to Jean Cor Vigilanthrum, Miss Harvest Homecoming 1996. Thank you so much, ladies. We appreciate you returning back to your home stage. We love you very much. And with that, I'll give the program back over to Brent.
There's a lot going on backstage right now. Recompose. There we go. In our program, you will see a breakdown of all prizes awarded at tonight's competition. All candidates received a gift bag full of goodies from the sponsors listed in the program. If you visit these businesses or any of our Harvest Homecoming sponsors, please mention that you saw them at the Miss Harvest Homecoming program and thank them for sponsoring our competition. Remember, the Miss America system is the largest provider of scholarships to women in the nation. Thanks to the Harvest Homecoming Festival and its many supporters. I'll regroup. Thanks to the Harvest Homecoming organization and their many sponsors for their support. Be sure to check out these sponsors in your program, which was provided by BG Reed & Sons, Inc. and designed by Jeff Finn. It's beautiful, and let's get a big round of applause for all of our sponsors this year. Well, you know, I've emceed a lot of events in my life, and never have I had a fake baby doing real crying backstage at a pageant. This is a first for me. If we could please raise the house lights, we'd like to recognize some special people who have supported our candidates, not just for this competition, but through their lives. If you are a parent of one of our outstanding teen candidates, please stand. If you are a parent of one of our Miss Harvest Homecoming candidates, please stand. We'd also like to recognize the parents of our reigning queens. Would the parents of Madeline Stewart and Skylar Adwell please stand? Thank you for your support of your queens and the festival. We truly appreciate you. We would also like to introduce some other special guests in our audience today. Please stand and be recognized when your name is called. Please welcome Elise Edwards, Miss Harvest Homecoming Preteen 2015. Aubrey Waltz, Miss Harvest Homecoming Preteen 2014. Ali Ballou, Miss Harvest Homecoming 2016. They put it in front of me, Irene. We'll also recognize Samantha Robbins, Miss Ball State. Elise Edwards, Miss Northeast Outstanding Teen. Ella Doddridge, Miss Three Rivers Festival's Outstanding Teen. We'd also like to recognize some Harvest Homecoming VP and Executive Board members. Polly Niemeyer. Woo! Tony Henderson. Woo! Courtney Lewis. Woo! Jeff Cummins. Woo! And Joe Oldrick. We'd also like to ask if any of our Harvest Homecoming officials, directors, and vice presidents please stand and be recognized. So I can tell you, it takes a lot of people, hours, and energy to put on a festival that over 700,000 people enjoy each year. And what makes it more special is that everyone involved is a volunteer, which speaks highly for our community. Thanks to everyone for their hard work and dedication with our festival. We'd also like to welcome New Albany Mayor Jeff Gahan with his wife, Susie. Jeff, it's always great to see you and Susie supporting these things. Thank you for being here. Last, but certainly not least, we would like to recognize the Pageant Committee. Vice President and Executive Director, Kara Lawson. Team Director, Lauren McNeely. Food Coordinator, Jane Alcorn. Little Miss Coordinator, Aaron Mikesell. Princess Camp Coordinator, Kara Duggan. Sponsorship Coordinator, Rosie Bryant. And Judges Chair, Dana McNeely. We'd also like to thank our stage manager, Crit Fisher. I don't know how you always get the most applause, Crit. Come out here, Crit, come out here. Let's Crit's always behind the scenes. We can't let Crit have a microphone. We'd also like to thank some of our helpers tonight, including Madeline Fisher, Caitlin Rowe, Allison Glass, Courtney Lewis, Logan Chapman, Suzanne House, Thomas House, Kia Black, Derek Brown, and Debbie Brown. And then certainly, up top, some of the Floyd Central Theater Department students, Sam Hendricks, Tyler Beck, and Hannah Tarr. Give them a big round. I know everyone's getting antsy to find out who our new queens will be, but first, we have three we need to hear from.
I'm not really sure how a farewell goes. I've never had to do this before, so I'm going to start out with to the next Miss Harvest Homecoming's outstanding team. Please soak up every single moment. It is the best experience you will ever have and one of the things that have taught me to work the hardest. Being a title holder is not easy, but makes you walk around with some type of pride. A humble pride that I wouldn't have ever gotten here without these people. My number one, Mom. Mom, thank you for the endless hours, days, months, years, just the constant support you give me. I am so thankful for you and everything you do to contribute to my happiness. I love you long time, Mama, forever. Tom, thank you for being so supportive of my year, making sure I was comfortable and always had everything I needed, such as bun cakes. Love you, the Schneiders. Thank you for being at all of the events you could be and showering me with so much support. I love you guys forever. Madeline, I wish I knew how to thank someone so much. I'm so thankful you're my sister queen. Love the bond we have and love you long time, sis. To my whole Harvest Homecoming family, I love every single one of you and can't get in depth because you all know I will cry endlessly. Good thing though, you're stuck with me now. To all of my other friends and family, I can't.
can't thank you all enough for the support and love I've been shown. My sisters, Abby and Leanna, I love you all long time. Thank you for the support no matter how annoying I am. Family is forever. Cole and Michael, my best friends during this Indiana week. I love you guys more than words can explain. My laughing buddies forever. Katie, thanks for being the best voice coach ever. I could not have done any of this without you. The Edwards, I love you all. Thank you for getting me to where I am today in this wonderful organization. Kara and Lauren, so thankful I was able to be the first team queen watching you guys work as a duo. I love you both so much and the constant faith you have always put into me. The lessons that you guys have taught me, I'm not going to say I'll never procrastinate again, but it will definitely happen less often. I love you guys so much and can't wait to see our relationships grow past the friends. To my sweet Jamie girl, I didn't forget about you. You are the best princess ever. You're my girl for life, and I knew you were my firecracker since the day I met you. I love you to death. And finally, all of our sponsors. We can't thank you enough. Thank you for spoiling Madeline and I all year. To the next Miss Harvest Homecoming's outstanding team. Girl, this is a job, the best job you will ever have. Be prepared to be pulled down by a 100-pound dog and break your shoe. Thanks for the extra support. I love you already and can't wait to see the bond be built. Take care, everyone, for me. For the last time, I am your Miss Harvest Homecoming outstanding team, Skylar Adwell.
Our first runner-up, the Miss Harvest Homecoming's outstanding team, and the recipient of a $300 scholarship is Lexi Stiles. Welcome back to the stage for the last time, Miss Harvest Homecoming's outstanding team 2018, as she takes her final walk, Skylar Adwell.
Support carried me through my entire year. Thank you for those early morning 8-hour drives just so I could have a mock interview. Dad, thanks for making me laugh and always making me feel like a mad dog. You both make me feel valued every day and I love you more than anything. To Sis and Debbie, you are both like second moms to me, and I will never go without thanking you both for all you've done. From driving to support me at locals to getting hotel rooms and being there for every night of prelim competition, if you didn't scream the loudest for me, I don't know who did. To Nanny and Tammy, thank you for always supporting me in my biggest dreams and calling me your Miss America since I was a little girl. To Kara, I never knew a director could transcend the title and become a f- of being Miss Harvest Homecoming has been everything I thought it would be and more. God spoke to me in the words of Esther 4:14, and I knew that perhaps this was the moment I had been created for, to share my story with young women through I Am That Girl and inspire them to ignite their true potential. However, I would not have the right words to say without the vision and abundance that God placed before me. These thank yous are in no particular order. To my mom, you are a rock and your support carried me through my entire year. Thank you for those early morning 8-hour drives just so I could have a mock interview. Dad, thanks for making me laugh and always making me feel like a mad dog. You both make me feel valued every day and I love you more than anything. To Sis and Debbie, you are both like second moms to me, and I will never go without thanking you both for all you've done. From driving to support me at locals to getting hotel rooms and being there for every night of prelim competition, if you didn't scream the loudest for me, I don't know who did. To Nanny and Tammy, thank you for always supporting me in my biggest dreams and calling me your Miss America since I was a little girl. To Kara, I never knew a director could transcend the title and become a friend to me, but you've done just that. Preparing for the festival in Miss Indiana was a whirlwind, but what I'll always remember is the way we could sit at your kitchen table and talk about God for hours. I'll always be your girl. To Lauren, although we didn't spend as much time together this year, you've done such an incredible job, and I'm so proud of all you've accomplished as a director. To Skylar, what am I going to do when I don't have your crazy self around all the time anymore? I've gained a real sister from this. You've been my partner in crime through it all, and I'll always be there for you to look up to as you continue to grow and make others smile like you've made me. To all the Harvest Homecoming volunteers, I've truly gained an orange family. From your soft hugs to the Underwoods' precious baby, to spending time with Scott and Kathy or meeting the mayor with Courtney, you have all supported my vision for the city of New Albany and cheered me on. But most importantly, you've become friends and family that I can reach out to for the gift of love. To the next title holder, I'm so ecstatic that you've stepped up and had the courage to compete for this job. You are more than prepared, but I still have a few words of wisdom for you. First, don't tie your success to anything other than what's inside you. Second, remember that in order to be a star, you must shine your own light. Lastly, I challenge you to make the next year a period of magnificent transformation for yourself, because it doesn't matter if you win. What matters is that you reach the truest, highest expression of yourself in the process. As for my next move, I'll be taking Oprah Winfrey's advice and the advice I give to every young woman I've touched through my social impact. I will create the highest, grandest vision possible for my life, because you become what you believe. For the last time, I'm the Miss Harvest Homecoming 2018, Madeline Stewart.
I would like to welcome her to the stage as she takes her final walk, our Miss Harvest Homecoming 2018, Madeline Stewart. Thank you, Madeline, for an outstanding year of service. You made Harvest Homecoming proud.
And if you're a girl, chase all your dreams.
Let's give both ladies one more big round of applause to show our appreciation for their wonderful year of service. Would Miss Indiana and Miss Indiana's outstanding teen join me on stage? Show them our appreciation for being here tonight and serving our great Hoosier State this year. Assisting our queens tonight with the award presentation will be Miss Indiana, Tierra Taylor, and Miss Indiana's outstanding team, Abby Avery. Thank you both for being here this evening. Now the moments we've all been waiting for. We would like to invite all of our candidates back out onto the stage, please. And as they do so, give them one more big round of applause. Great job this evening, ladies. First, we'd like to present some special awards. Earlier today, each candidate was asked to nominate the candidate who was the friendliest and most helpful. Our Miss Teen Congeniality is KG Bouvier. Our Miss Congeniality is Elizabeth Palat. Now we get to present our candidates with the People's Choice Award winner, a portion of the proceeds raised tonight will be donated to the Children's Miracle Network, the national platform of the Miss America organization. Our Teen People's Choice Award goes to Lexi Stites. Our Miss People's Choice Award goes to Brooklyn Chalfont. As soon as we're finished taking photos, candidates and winners will be released to their families. We've seen a lot of talent and exciting competitions tonight. It appears that our auditors are ready, and they have tabulated the scores. We will announce our runners-up and Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen 2019 first. We then ask for the parents and friends of the teens to wait patiently as we award our runners-up and the new Miss Harvest Homecoming 2019. Okay, here we go. Second runner-up to Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen and recipient of a $100 scholarship is Leah Trusty. Runner-up to Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen and recipient of a $300 scholarship is KG Bouvier. Gentlemen, Miss Harvest Homecoming's Outstanding Teen 2019 and recipient of a $1,000 scholarship provided by the Harvest Homecoming Festival and a $250 provided by UPS is Lexi Stites. In the audience. Now it's time to move on to the Miss Candidates. second runner-up to Miss Harvest Homecoming, and recipient of an $800 scholarship is Brooklyn Chalfon. Runner-up to Miss Harvest Homecoming and recipient of a $1,000 scholarship is Meadow Ryan. Miss Harvest Homecoming 2019 and recipient of a $3,000 scholarship sponsored by the Harvest Homecoming Festival and a $250 scholarship sponsored by UPS is Elizabeth Hillel.
Photos for the queens and candidates. Thank you all and congratulations.